we've been studying fire since before we had electricity. And so we do know a lot about fire. There's a lot of long-term knowledge about how fire behaves in a system, how fire is good for systems, and why we need fire. But there are still fundamental questions about how we can study fire, how we can detect fire, and where we can detect fire. There's a real need for identifying technology that we can use, you know, here on an aircraft or on a sensor, as well as tools and technology that we can use in Earth orbit to help support proactive wildland fire management. Fire is a natural part of the Earth system, and because fire has been part of the Earth for so many thousands of years, we actually have fire-adapted ecosystems. And so in areas where you have regular wildfire, you require fire for that system to be healthy and resilient.
NASA FireSense is a project focused on developing and delivering NASA technology, including Earth observation data and modeling and science to land managers that manage wildland fire.
This week, we're partnering with Fort Stewart, which is in Georgia. And so an important part of the FireSense campaigns are these partnerships between a number of different types of agencies and collaborators.
Everything we do, you know, on test and training ranges has potential to start fires. And to mitigate that wildfire risk, we use a lot of prescribed fire, in fact, more than almost any other federal landowner.
By keeping these fuel levels so low like this, when we do have wildfires occur, they can be suppressed very easily. We don't have to interrupt military training. And then also on Fort Stewart, we have several threatened endangered species. This whole ecosystem is fire dependent out here. And so by implementing prescribed fire on a 2 to 3 year basis, that maintains that habitat for red cockaded woodpecker, gopher tortoise, eastern indigo snake, all these species of concern like that.
So this prescribed fire is in support of critical research that allows us to test and evaluate various satellites and airborne platforms to look at and study fire.
The multi-scale approach that we're employing here at Fort Stewart is something that we've been trying to do in the fire science community for a long time, and it's a very difficult thing to do. When you're working with fire that's very dynamic, getting everything to align along with the satellite observations is sort of been the holy grail in fire science for a long time.
The moving parts have been consistent, and there's quite a bit, and it tends to get complicated in the airspace.
It's really systematic. It starts right at the beginning before we even leave the office, based on that weather forecast and ensuring that everything's going to meet those prescription parameters.
On the spot weather forecast, up to 18 on the ground. But they're going to try to get the burn done before humidity goes down too low.
Particularly with NASA, safety is one our top mission, and we have a lot of reviews. And we're going to look at the details to the nth degree.
Ensuring that in the burn briefing, again, before we leave the office, ensuring that everything is prepped the way it needs to be, ensuring that we're going to be able to keep that burn in its block.
They're going to burn fast, like they say, every day. And it sounded like they're going to try to get out there and start burning within probably the next 40 minutes.
And then getting out on site and putting that first bit of fire on the ground, ensuring that test fire is indicating that the rest of the burn is going to go as we want it to, and going working through the whole process. Once that burn boss is comfortable with the distance that fire has backed off into the woods, he'll call in our helicopter. It'll come fly the perimeter, check everything out, assess the fire behavior, and the firing boss in the helicopter will communicate with the burn boss. And based on the fire behavior that they're both seeing, they'll start igniting that with the helicopter.
Roger, sounds good. Yeah, it's burning real well. Okay, sounds good.
We had to transit about an hour to get on target. And so we were always trying to get ahead of making our briefings and then getting the aircraft off on time so that we could coordinate to meet up with the ignition helicopter that was burning the unit.
There's a machine called a plastic sphere dispenser in the helicopter. that drops little ping pong ball size balls out of there, and they contain potassium permanganate inside of them. And when they run through the machine, they're injected with glycol for a delayed chemical reaction. About 30 to 40 seconds after they leave that machine, they'll just ignite in a very low intensity fire and help just grid out the whole unit.
We were over top to capture the beginning of the burn all the way through the end of the burn.
This whole unit, this whole 12 to 1300 acres, will be burned in about 45 minutes. It's extremely efficient.
That's really amazing that you can see it at that level of detail.
Yeah, do you see the plane?
Oh, that's cool.
There it is.
So it just updated. So within FireSense on the field campaigns for 2025, we have coordinated satellite, so sensors within Earth orbit. We have three crewed aircraft with four sensors on board looking at information before the fire happens, during the fire, and after the fire. And each of those sensors looks at different aspects of the system, and so they're giving you different information, so you can use that all together. And then we have ground sensors, and so all of these pieces together, we can use those to improve models in the long term, and then we can use them immediately to give information to burn crews so they know if they need to add more lines of ignition to a prescribed fire, or if they need to add resources to one side so that they can help contain a fire. It gives them information that they need immediately in real time.
And anything that provides us extra data for our decision making, for our why we did this particular day, anything that can help back up that decision making process is extremely beneficial.
All this knowledge that some of it has been broken traditionally over the years, or separated, but there's some cultures in the United States and certainly in other parts of the world that continue their way of burning. And now we have science in a way validating what happened and what is happening. And I think it'll help us in the future.
So much of what we manage across the continental United States depends on remote sensing. And so we hope that this effort validates those remote sensing platforms and allows organizations like NASA and its FireSense campaign to really support the broader wildland fire community, the broader fire community and the urban interface by really providing real-time assets with quality control validation in the field, so that as we address the nation's wildfire challenges, we do so with the best available tools and technology.
Ship disk is mounted. One of the exciting parts of this spring 2025 campaign for FireSense is we're getting feedback on real-time data. And so one of those systems is the NASA JPL Avarice 3 system. We have real-time spectroscopic products. And what that gives us is a picture of what's happening during a fire. And so you can see active fire progression. Every couple of minutes, it will give you a picture of where the fire is. Right now, we're getting feedback through a technician who's on the ground that can then talk to the burn crew on the fire line and provide feedback on what's useful, what they like, and then make adjustments.
Avarice 3 is a digital sensor, and unlike a digital camera that shows us, you know, a regular image, we are able to see many more wavelengths with Avarice because they use a diffraction grating that's able to split the light into these hundreds of wavelengths instead of just a few.
What we're doing is we're measuring the light from the ground or sunlight reflected from the ground. So we're not sending any signal down from the instrument, but everything that's from the Earth's surface is coming up and through this window into the instrument.
This is brand new, especially at this pace. So the 3 to 5 minute downlink of data is really cutting edge, and it's really exciting to have that near real time product that we're able to provide to the foresters and the fire managers on the ground. On our campaign a few weeks ago, Avarice was able to spot new wildfires while they were flying.
We ended up flying more wildfires than we initially had anticipated, but that was also due to the weather and the situation that was happening. We gave our sensor teams and our pilots some ability to make corrections in the air, and we had communication with our
with our teams so that we could be dynamic and be really responsive to this very unplanned environment.
I was able to pull that data down within a few minutes and provide maps of new starts to forestry managers on the ground who are able to deploy resources to these wildfires. So in that context, that near real-time pace is really critical for deploying resources and managing those wildfires and protecting property and things like that.
With satellite collection, you have to identify the time that the satellite is passing over. And so you get persistent coverage with crewed aircraft in comparison to a satellite.
We might get 2 to 4 looks at a fire per day, which, you know, is really useful information, but it doesn't have that high temporal frequency. When we can do this from aircraft and send data down almost immediately from the plane, we get that added perspective of delivering that higher resolution time information.
Fire is a mobile disturbance. And so fire impacts all aspects of the Earth system. It's going to impact the soil. It's going to impact the vegetation. It creates smoke, which is then carried through the air. So it impacts our atmosphere. The fire behavior itself generates its own weather. And so because of all of these different systems, we need different scientists who have expertise in all of these pieces. And so on campaigns, we have integrated teams so that we have integrated data.
Collaboration is built into fire management, whether it's initial attack and mutual aid response or research and development. We all bring certain perspectives, tools, technology to research. And in this case, to be able to deploy them together gives us synergies that just would not be possible if we go it alone.
The way that FireSense will be successful is by working directly with local partners so that we can support decision making that they're doing on the ground.
In other words, this helps us flatten out the training curve. You know, fires are getting more and more intense, more and more severe, and being in places where it's been rare historically for them to be. So the next generation of fire scientists and firefighters are going to have something to anchor into as they progress in future and changing conditions.